would you love me? Never would you leave me. But the devil take that woman, for you know she treat me easy. Push your ring, dumma do dumma da. Now some men like a vision, and some men like a violin, and some men like to hear. But here I am in prison. Here I am with a ball and chain, yeah. But your ring, dumma do dumma da. Wait for my daddy, oh. Wait for my daddy, oh. There's whiskey in the jar.
Hello, hello, hello. Let me see if this thing's working. Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello, welcome back. Let me see if this is... Change my audio input. I think we're working. Just testing, testing. See if this is working. See if we can get this thing working properly with my audio. With my audio. With my audio and the microphone. This thing working properly with my audio. Okay. Hello again. Welcome back to Video Gamers Oasis on Twitch. I'm your lovable, huggable host, Jeremy. Taking a break from my gaming videos. My Minecraft videos. I know I really enjoy those Minecraft videos. I find them very relaxing. I've been really wanting to get back into my guitar routine. I used to play the guitar a lot as a hobby. And I have here the software CD. Teach Yourself to Play Guitar. It was a gift from my dad many years ago. And I never took the time to install it. Never took a time to use it. So now I'm going to take this opportunity to do some... I'm going to see if I can make this daily, if not a few days a week, of this software CD. I'm going to reteach myself how to play guitar. I used to have a teacher named Bob Cunningham in London, Ontario, Old South, and he taught me everything he knew about acoustic guitar. He was very much like a folksy kind of singer. He had his own little band called Triumby Croft, and he taught me a lot of different songs, how to do chord progressions. I had a good time with learning. Of course, my health was not the best back then. I couldn't fully appreciate what I was doing and couldn't fully appreciate how great of a teacher he was. So in his honor, in my dad's honor, I'm going to reteach myself how to play guitar. And with this CD program, lessons, I'm going to have individual lessons for each video. I'm also going to try to do more gaming videos as well, just to mix things up and like a bit of a mixed salad. So I don't just focus on one thing, but I have a variety of different projects on this Twitch channel. So hope you join me for this journey. I'm going to have a good time. I'm going to set up my little workstation, broadcast station, so I can this CD here, it's a CD-ROM. I don't know if many of us use CD-ROMs anymore, but this has individual video lessons in sort of a QuickTime format. Not the highest quality video, but it's pretty good. And it also, and it's this dude playing the guitar and teaches you how to play guitar step by step. So I'm going to do the introduction only today and see how we move on from that. So let's get my gaming workstation first. I'm going to get my gaming workstation. Just want to set this up a bit. I'm going to copy this. Duplicate. All right, and we're going to rename this duplicate. Let's teach yourself guitar. Teach yourself to play guitar live. CD-ROM. And we'll go on from there. So we got that over here. Teach yourself to play guitar. I just had it a moment ago. Here we go. Teach yourself to play guitar live. I'm going to just make sure my audio is working. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, okay. Now I'm going to change the graphic of the box from Dracula's Curse to Teach Yourself. Add that over there. Just over the box so it's the same size. Okay. And we're just going to, what we're going to do now, next is we're going to get the Castlevania cover art and we're going to remove that. Okay. And we're going to make sure our broadcast is working. And we're going to change that from Castlevania to, we're going to have a simple screen capture. Like that. And let's see if we can delete that for a moment. And you wonder what I'm doing. I'll just explain to you in a moment. I'm going to get my Minecraft broadcast a moment. Just a moment here. And I'm going to get this. I'm going to copy. Copy and then go to my shelf guitar and I'm going to paste that and I'm going to, because it's cropping the stuff I don't want people to see basically. Let's get this thing kind of set up here, make sure it fits perfectly in the required space. Very good. I think we're just about ready. Okay. Bum, bum, bum. Let's test the sound. I want to look at my Twitch to make sure I'm broadcasting properly. Testing. Testing. We're just Twitch testing to make sure I'm broadcasting properly. Yep, it's working. Okay. We'll start our software for introduction level only. So let's get on with it. Maximize that. Look at my screen. All right, let's see if that works. If this works, I'm going to continue doing this every day, if as much as I can. All right, just the introduction. Here we go. The dude sitting on his chair with his acoustic guitar, and he's got an electric guitar on his left side, and an amplifier, and some guitars on a stand, and there's a whiteboard behind him. See what he has to say.
Hi, and welcome.
Hey, what's
my
up?
My name's Jeff, and I'm
nice
going
to
be your
you,
guide through this Teach Yourself to Play Guitar CD-ROM. Now, before we get started, there's a couple things I'm going to cover. First of all, when you want to advance to the next section of the program, just click the arrow in the upper left-hand corner of your screen.
Okay.
Now, before we actually get started playing, I'm going to teach you a couple things about different kinds of guitars, about guitar maintenance, and about how to tune your guitar.
All right.
Well, let's get going. Click on that arrow, and we'll move on to the next part of the program.
Okay. Let's move that arrow forward. It wasn't much of a video, so let's move on. Not very long, 50 seconds. All right, I want to move the arrow. Acoustic guitars. He's going to teach me acoustic guitars, I think.
All right, let's talk about the different types of guitars, starting with acoustic guitars. There are two basic types of acoustic guitars.
Okay.
We have the acoustic flat top guitar, which has a flat top, a narrow neck, and steel strings. And they're played either with a flat pick or with finger picks. And they're used in rock, blues, and folk guitar. And they sound something like this.
Okay, so far so good.
The classical guitar is our second type of acoustic guitar, and it also has a flat top, but it has a bit of a wider neck, and it has nylon strings, and it's always played with the fingers. It sounds something like this.
Spanish guitar. All right, that was 50 seconds of that lesson, acoustic guitars. Let's move on to the next one. I think it's electric guitars. Here we go. We're just getting started.
All right, let's talk about electric guitars. There are two basic types of electric guitars. The first is the solid body. It's got a solid body, a narrow neck, and light gauge steel strings. It's also got
guitar one time.
And the signal from an electric guitar gets fed through an amplifier and sometimes other effects like a wah pedal, distortion, or chorus. This kind of guitar is generally used in rock, country, blues, and jazz. And it sounds a little something like this.
He's really jamming it.
All right.
Very good.
The next type of electric guitar we're going to talk about is a semi-hollow. It has
semi-hollow.
A semi-hollow body, and it has these F-holes,
semi-hollow.
Which give it a warmer, richer tone than a solid body guitar. It's also got a narrow neck and light gauge steel strings. This kind of guitar is generally used in jazz and blues, and it sounds a little something like this.
It does have a bluesy sound to it. B.B. King. And on to the next one. Caring for your guitar. Okay, I wish I could magnify this. Like, it's difficult to me to read that. Is there any way we could get a magnifier here? Magnifier app. Okay, let's get that over here. Let's read this a little bit better. All right, let's see what the photographs reads first. The Who took a larger-than-life approach to rock performance, perhaps inspired by guitarist Pete Townshend's compositions, which were as theatrical as they were powerful. Included among these was rock's first opera, Tommy, released in 1969. All right, most guitar care is simply common sense. Rule one is to never expose the instrument to the extremes of heat or cold. In the corner of my room, I have a guitar case with a fake fur interior, which protects it from heat and cold, from the elements. All right, rule number two. Rule number two is to make sure the strings are tuned to an accurate pitch. Tuning the strings too high can have serious consequences for the instrument, causing the neck to bow, or the bridge to rip out of the top. Pretty straightforward. Rule three is to wipe the strings off after playing and polish the instrument using guitar polish. Well, I guess I'm going to have to invest in some guitar polish from now on. Wipe the strings off. Wipe them off from now on. Because I guess they get full of saliva or sweat from the fingers. Finally, rule four is to have a repairman check over the instrument twice a year just before the summer and winter. All right, well, I'm going to have to remember that. Let's see if I can snapshot this picture for just so I can keep track of this and keep a note. So I'm going to get my handy dandy snapshot Screen Grab Pro, and I'm going to grab this image like this, and I'm going to snap it like this. Now file, save as JPEG, and I'm gonna say the four rules of guitar care. We'll just save that for now. Okay, that's a lesson, I guess. Are we actually gonna have a lesson, actually? Nope, we're just gonna have that little text, a little note. So moving on to the next section, tuning your guitar. Okay, this ought to be interesting. Magnifier, let's read this a little bit closer. Okay. All right, tune your guitar. Click on the tuning pegs and tune your guitar to match the pitch. First string E, second string B, third string G, fourth string D, fifth string A, and sixth string E. Select Guitar Tuner from the Start menu to tune your guitar using the tuner. Oh, that's going to be interesting. Tuning your guitar to itself. E, A, D, G, B, and E. Fret 1, fret 2, fret 3, fret 4, and fret 5. We have the A, D, G, B, E. Press 5th fret of 6th string to get pitch of 5th string A. Press 5th fret of 5th string to get pitch of 4th string D. Press 5th fret of 4th string to get pitch of 3rd string G. Press 4th fret of 3rd string to get pitch of 2nd string B. Press 5th fret of 2nd string to get pitch of 1st string E. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to give this a little bit of a snapshot using my handy dandy Screen Grab Pro. Let's get this little snapshot here. And we'll save this as get this cropped here right up close. Save this as tuning your guitar. Tuning your guitar. Save that. Very good. So I think we're good for that. I'm going to select Guitar Tuner from the Start menu to tune your guitar using the tuner. So where would I find that? From the Start menu? I don't know where to find that. I'm going to just move forward. We'll worry about that later. Oh, I just the start menu. So if I type in guitar tuner. Oh, right there. There's a guitar tuner right there. Oh, cool. It has a very sensitive, it has a sensor that senses guitar tunes. Cool. How would that work? This is pretty neat. It tells you all the notes. Auto tune. Oh, neat. Well, that's really cool. I'm gonna have to use this in the future. This is so awesome. I can tune my guitar using the computer. That's so neat. All right, let's move on. See how many more lessons we have before we'll take a break. Holding a guitar.
There are several correct ways to hold a guitar.
Okay.
Sitting like this.
Okay.
With your legs crossed like okay. This.
Like this. Ah! Cross my arm.
Or standing with a strap like this.
Like this.
Try each position to get the feel of each one.
All right, that's pretty straightforward. Okay. Move on. Hand positions. Learn about some hand positions.
Now let's talk about left hand technique. Okay. Notice that the thumb falls nearly opposite the knuckles on the second and third fingers. Now keep your elbow in, keep your fingers curved, and when you place a left hand finger on the guitar, you want to press firmly and as close to the fret as possible without actually being on it. This will ensure a clean, bright tone. Proper right hand technique using a pick involves holding the pick firmly between the thumb and forefinger, but not so firmly that you create tension in the arm. You want it to be loose. And then you're going to strum down with the wrist in a sweeping motion like this. You don't want to move the whole arm, just the wrist. And you want to practice because that might take some getting used to. So don't use the pick, use the heel of your thumb like this. Guitar notation and diagrams, please note that all the fingers on the left hand correspond to numbers. The index finger is number one, the middle finger is number two, the ring finger is number three, and the pinky is number four.
Okay. I'm going to make a note of that.
Now let's talk about left hand tip. The index finger is number one. Correspond to numbers. The index finger is number one, the middle finger is number two, the ring finger is number three, and the pinky is number four.
Okay, let's do a little snapshot of that. Snapshot the image. All right. Finger numbers. 1 to 4. Pretty straightforward. Moving on. Notes and the staff.
You may already know that musical sounds are indicated by symbols called notes. Their time value is determined by their color, black or white, and by the stems and flags attached to the note. The name and pitch of the note are determined by the note's placement on a staff. The staff is a graph comprised of 5 horizontal lines and the spaces in between.
Okay.
The notes are named after the first 7 letters of the alphabet, A through G, and are repeated to embrace the entire range of musical sound.
Okay, I'm going to make a note of that. A snapshot.
The staff is a graph comprised of 5.
All right, we're just going to take a snapshot of this image so I can look at it later. my handy dandy Snapshot Pro. Okay. Save this as notes and the staff. Okay, good. I'll look at that later.
At horizontal lines.
I'm starting to get a little bit hungry, so I'm going to have to take a break
soon.
The
notes are named after the first seven letters of the alphabet, A through G, and are repeated to embrace the entire range of musical sound.
All right, good. Next video, measures and clefs.
Music is also divided into equal parts or units called measures.
Okay.
One measure is divided from another by a bar line. During the evolution of music notation, the staff had anywhere from 2 to 20 lines, and cymbals were invented to locate a reference line or pitch by which all other pitches were determined. These cymbals are called clefs. Music for the guitar is written in the G or treble clef.
Okay. We'll just look at this one more time.
Music is also divided into equal parts or units called measures.
We'll make a snapshot of this. All right, save this as getting started, measures and clefs, part one. All right.
One measure is divided from another by a bar line.
Okay.
During the evolution of music notation, the staff had anywhere from 2 to 20 lines, and cymbals were invented to locate a reference line or pitch by which all other pitches were determined. These cymbals are called clefs.
Okay, clefs. I'll make a snapshot of this. Save this. We'll save this as getting started. Part two. All right.
Music for the guitar is written in the G or treble clef.
All right. We're going to take a break here, folks, because I am getting really feeling hungry. I need to eat some lunch. So we'll take a little break here. And folks, that was Teach Yourself Guitar. We just get started, actually. We're just getting started. The CD, there's a link, Amazon link. You can buy the software yourself. I highly recommend it for that special someone in your life who likes guitars, who wants to learn. I'm enjoying this so far. It's very educational. I'm just scratching the surface. I'm not actually playing guitar today, but I will be playing in the future. So I hope you'll join me for that. I'm going to make a series of these videos in the future. So I hope you'll stay followed on my Twitch channel, Video Gamers Oasis. Tune in a little bit later today. I'm going to be playing some more Dracula's Curse. Maybe some Minecraft if I have time and energy. I want to get more videos, more flow of videos going on Twitch, this Twitch channel. Because I've been kind of in a lockdown mode for quite too long. I'm going to get back into the routine of making videos. So thanks so much for tuning in. Thanks so much. I appreciate you taking the time to go on this journey with me. Have a great lunch time or a great relaxation time today if you get some time to relax. And we'll see you again real soon. All right. Bye for now.